Hey, what's up? This is Tristan. This is another of the drone series video. In this short video, we will cover what you can do on the remote of your DJI drone to make sure that you get away from as much interference as possible. So DJI has a system in the app that you will be able to see the different channels and how busy any of the channels might be. So that will give you great insight, pick the right channel depending on how busy they might be. So let's jump right into it and look what you would do on the app.
All right, so you've connected your drone to the app, your phone is connected to the remote. So I'm seeing currently what my drone is seeing. So before taking off or doing any flight, what I would advise you to do is go back here on the three dots to pick your options. Once you're there, pick the one that looks like the Wi-Fi icon. This will lead you to this page here. So this actually shows you all the different channels. Usually you will directly be on auto mode and pretty much the drone will pick whatever channels they think is the most suitable before your flight. But I would advise you to try to understand what's going on and maybe pick one on your own. So to do so, you will have to first go on custom. This will now let you see the list of the channels. So for the longest time, I tried to here switch between 2.4 and 5.8. And actually the way to do so is which number of the channel you will pick. The channel from 1 to 11, I believe, yes, is 2.4 gigahertz. And the channels with three digits, so channel 149 all the way to 165, will be 5.8 gigahertz. You look at those channels and you can see which ones are stable, which one are unstable, and which channel you're currently on. So it seems like there's not a lot going on channel 3. So let's go ahead and pick that one instead. So click on it, it will restart it. They will let you know that you're connected to that channel now. That's it. That's pretty much all you have to do. So I would advise you to kind of like take a minute and kind of like see which channel get busy to really make sure that you make the best decision here. Because once you pick a channel and you start flying the drone, you won't be able to go back and change anything. You will pretty much have to bring the drone back, land it, and then you would be able to switch channel. Take a few minutes to pick the most optimal channel before you even start flying.
I hope you guys found that video useful. That's what I've been using for several months to make sure that I pick the best channel possible before flying. It's really improved the connection between my remote and the drone, so I advise you to try as well. If you have any other questions, please let me know below and I'll make sure to answer them. Thank you so much and I'll see you in the next video. Bye.